Good evening, guys. Apologies for the delay. We'll take questions from English-speaking media first and then Spanish-speaking media after that. Please raise your hand so let us know you'd like to ask a question. We'll come to as many of you as possible. So where to start, please? Anyone? Simon? Have we got microphones? No?
I cannot hear you.
Of course we have the experience of last year, but we don't think much on that. To be fair, we know that we're gonna face different Real Madrid. They play different, and every season is different. I think we came here with one of the best shapes right now of ourselves in the season. So I think we're gonna face always the favorites in this competition. We already know each other quite well, to be fair, the last years. And we expect such a tough game tomorrow.
Just here on the call. Thank you. Richard.
Hi, Rodri. Real Madrid have had a week off because they didn't play any football in the week because of the Copa del Rey final. You guys are in a title race. Do you think that rest is an advantage to them, or do you guys like to be focused every 3 days playing?
Well, I'll tell you tomorrow what the result is. Of course, we're involved in the Premier League fight, and this makes you play every 3 days and play with everything and not rest. And they have, I think because they have the final of the Copa del Rey, they could rest a little bit more. And it's something that maybe they have a bit advantage in this sense. Let's see how the team responds tomorrow physically. But it's something that we are not worried because we have the experience of other years, and this team has been playing this kind of stages with the same rhythm of games the last year. So, of course, we would like to rest like them, but it's something that doesn't worry us.
David?
Hi, Rodri. You said it would be a different Real Madrid and they're playing a different way. One of the big differences will be Jude Bellingham. How impressed have you been with the way he has adapted and been such a success in his first season here at Real Madrid?
Well, I think I said we face a different Real Madrid because I think they play different. I think they don't play in the same way. I think they control more the games. They have more midfielders and different kind of playing. Of course, we expect, like always, so tough here in Bernabeu. We know that whatever happened never is going to be finished, even though the things go good or bad tomorrow. We know we have the second leg. Of course, about Jude, we already know particularly because we faced them lots of times against Dortmund. We know the type of player he is, so powerful, so strength with ability of going and arriving in the second line and controlling the game. So, we already know, but I don't like focusing just on one player. I think they have enormous potential in all the lines. And what I can say is what we know is they play kind of different. They have more control of the game with this kind of players, and we have to adapt ourselves to that.
Ben?
Hi, Rodri. Obviously, a lot was made of your loss here 2 seasons ago, and you righted some of the wrongs last season. Is that how it felt from a squad? Because I remember you talking and players talking about that specific defeat here as being something quite traumatic that you had to process. And then last season, by beating Real Madrid so convincingly, did you prove to yourselves and everyone else that you can be the best team in the world?
I think we prove ourselves every time we play against them, to be fair. I mean, this is the fourth time against them.
Four times.
And in all of them, we have great results. The one you talk about when we didn't go through in the semi-finals, we all know what happened. Was about 10-15 minutes, and it's something that happened in football. We didn't think much about that last year, and this is why we play with the desire, you know, with the fire inside that we want to win it again for what happened. But to be fair, now we are a more mature team. We have the experience of winning this competition, and we came here with a different mentality, with more composure. And to be fair, we know that nothing is going to be done tomorrow. We need to have a good result, to be fair, because we know how tough it is here in Bernabeu. But I see the team more mature. I hope that the experience of winning this tournament give us tomorrow the confidence to do the things right.
Fred, on this side, please, Roger.
Hi, Rodri. You just mentioned the experience of winning the competition. What do you think is the difference when you visit the king of the Champions League when you are the ones wearing the crown?
Well, as I said, Jopan, I think it gives you a little bit more of, I don't know how to say in English, composure, serenity on the pitch. And you learn, of course, we learn from the past, we learn from when we lose and also when you win. And I think having both experience in overall, I think we are a completely more mature team that the first time we faced them, I remember here in Bernabeu. So it gives us confidence. We cannot confuse ourselves. We need to bring the best of ourselves if we want to compete against this team, because they're always favorite in this competition and more here at home. But we know them quite well, how we have to fight them, how we have to play against them. And it's something that, as I tell you, we've been learning from the past.
Ian?
Rodri, hello. We're looking at two managers who've had the most wins in the history of the Champions League, two elite managers. As far as Pep Guardiola is concerned, what makes him stand out, in your opinion? Give us a bit of insight as to his special qualities.
Of Pep? What can I say about Pep? I mean, I think you watch it, right? The last years. You're talking about maybe the two most success coaches in the history of this tournament, of the Champions League, Ancelotti and Pep. I think both with their own style, but two winners in their own way. And what I can say about my manager is our leader in this sense. And tomorrow, like always, we will need the best of him to bring that to the team in terms of the speech, in terms of tactics, in terms of energy, positive energy for us. He's, of course, very, very important. And every year, it never goes down, you know, the importance of this manager for us.
One last question in English for Paul, please. Just on this side, please, Rodri.
Yeah. Hey, Rodri. Was this time last season, the quarterfinals, the semi-finals, where City started hitting your kind of top level in terms of performances? How close do you think you are as a team to that level now this year?
Well, I think, to be fair, the last two games we had in Premier League, we show quite a big Ingrid, on the performance, on scoring goals. That was, I think, a task we have so far the last month. We didn't score much goals, and now we are arriving with a lot of players in the box, and I think we're showing the best shape. Of course, we all know we have downs, we have injuries, important players out, and it's going to be important. But in the same way, I'm so confident about the team is going to play tomorrow, about my teammates, because all of them, they're top-level players, and if I will ask something to my teammates tomorrow, is apart from giving everything, is to play, as I said before, with the serenity and composure that we are the winners and that we want to do it again. And we cannot confuse ourselves. We have to give the best of ourselves and be humble enough to know that we came to the champions, the 14 champions of this competition. So we have to be humble enough to know that we have to run more, do more, and play better than them tomorrow.
Okay, we'll move into some questions from Spanish media.
Sí. ¿Qué tal, Rodri? Melchor Ruiz, Cadena.
Hello, Rodri. Melchor Ruiz, Cadena Cope. You say that Real Madrid is the favourite team because of its history, because of the deployment at Bernabeu, although the bets say that Manchester City is the king right now. They're holding the title. Now you're playing your second game at home, and you're playing about Real Madrid that is different because of the way they play, and maybe the midfielders could be the key of the game. Do you like to have the ball, and the best way to defend against Real Madrid that will try to press you and to play quickly maybe would be to have the ball and to control that way of playing? Yeah, well, it's clear they've changed the way they play, but they haven't changed their essence. I mean, Real Madrid, the way they play the games, they think of the games, they have very vertical players that can hurt us in counter-attacks. And it's true that they are controlling the games much more because they have another player in the inside, but they are getting to the box equally. So with Jude Bellingham, with Vinicius, Rodrigo, they're players that appear a lot in these areas, in the box, etc. They have a very long path, so we need to pay attention to them. But of course, one of our skills would be to try to control our rival with the ball and to have personality. What I would ask our teammates is to have personality to play, as we've always done in this stadium, if we want to have a positive result. Here, Rodri, Luis Cobo for OK Diario. I wanted to ask you about Vinicius. Tomorrow he's warned, he's one yellow card away from being penalised. Will you try to look for that yellow card? And do you think that the area of the field where he plays could be dangerous? Well, we usually are given this information before the game, who has a yellow card, who doesn't. We are not concerned about it, of course. He's an important player. But we focus on our stuff, we focus on what we're going to do on the pitch, the way we want to play, and we don't know whether they are about to be penalised or not. Hello, Rodri. Marcelo Duval from Dosis Futbolera. A few days ago, we knew a statement from you that you were speaking about the differences between the Premier League and La Liga, and you said that sometimes you thought that they were two different sports. So do you think tomorrow the sport will be the same? Maybe the Real Madrid is the most similar team to a Premier League team? What would you say about it? Well, good question. I think that I have not been asked this question yet. That's clear. I gave my reasons why the leagues are different, and when we need to adapt to every league, when you get to a European competition like Champions League, where we have different styles, different paths, different rhythms, they all come together, so it's very complex for both teams. For us, because we're playing against a team that we are not accustomed to play against, and for them, we always have our virtues. Of course, they have many virtues. They are Real Madrid. Maybe they are the team that is the most fit in the Spanish League, in the European League, but well, the positive part is that we know each other very well. We have played against each other four times in the last 5 years, and I think that we know each other very well. So I think that that wouldn't make the difference, I would say. Hello, Rodri. Miguel Angel Marca from Marca. You've said that you always try to watch videos, etc. So how much... what do you think about Toni Kroos? What do you think about his the position where he plays on the pitch? Well, I like to watch football. I like to watch great players as Toni Kroos, of course. And we are all aware that maybe it's not the same profile of player that I am, although we are playing the same position. But of course, he is a player that needs to be taken into account because, of course, he is, I would say, the metronome, the one that is setting the pace of the team, I would say. And we need to be aware of the areas where he likes to play, his strengths. We should know that he moves the team from one side to another, and we need to stick close to him. I think Real Madrid depends a lot on Toni Kroos, I would say. And as I always say, players like Toni, I mean, we don't have many in the world that have this capacity of taking that pace. So this is why it is a player that needs to be taken into account.
Hola, ¿qué tal, Rodri?
Yeah, hello, Rodri. Javier Reyes from Cadena Ser. I wanted to ask you if you think that that competition, when we saw that picture of Guardiola with people, with four goals, etc., do you think that in the locker room you're a player, do you think that that could be a little bit annoying? Maybe that kind of football also plays a role in this kind of games? Well, everything that we see with this healthy specificity, always respect the rival. Well, I always say this. In football, we need to respect our rivals because we always know what happens. A rivalry is always good if it's with respect. And of course, we were coming from a very difficult year with that. Well, we wanted to come across the elimination the year before, and it was very beautiful the way we did it because the team was able to win its first Champions League, and we have to reset everything right now. Another battle, a different game, and we hope that it has the same ending.
Yes.